Some of my experiences in applications of parametric and non-parametric tests in statistical data analysis. Here I have divided my presentation into following topics like basic introduction, parametric, non-parametric tests, where we have to apply these tests, practical exercise based on our decided software, that is SPSS. Before going to these tests, let us see what is sample, what is large sample, what is small sample. Even though you are familiar, just I am repeating that one. Sample is a part of population which represents the whole population. That is known as sample. How many samples are collected in a sample to represent the population? That is indicating sample size. In this example, from the population, 10 samples are collected. 10 size samples are collected to represent the population. Based on the sample size, sample can be classified as large sample and small sample. If the sample size is greater than 30, then we can treat as a large sample. If it is less than 30, we can treat as a small sample. Why I am telling, many tests are depending on sample size also. That's why I'm giving some overview of this one. This is about sample. Let us see what is parametric test, what is non-parametric test. These are some basic brief differences. Coming to parametric test, if the distribution of population is assumed to be known, that is normal distribution, then whatever test apply for the data, those tests are known as parametric tests. If the distribution of population is assumed to be not known, for those data, if you want to apply any test, non-parametric tests are recommendable. So simply, these are called as distribution-free tests. Coming to how to choose parametric and non-parametric test. First of all, based on the important thing is based on data. Whenever your type of data is ratio scale or interval scale, at that situation, parametric tests are recommended. Whenever your type of data is either nominal or ordinal in scale, at that situation, non-parametric tests are majorly recommended. Already yesterday, it was covered regarding types of scaling, nominal, ordinal, interval ratio. That's why I'm not again repeating that one. Yeah, coming to preferable measure of central tendency in case of parametric test is median. Sorry, mean. Coming to non-parametric test, it is median. For one test, if you want to apply parametric, both non-parametric, which one is powerful? Mean, parametric test is more powerful because it is based on many assumptions, like data should be normally distributed, variance should be homogeneous. Many assumptions are there. That's why parametric tests are comparatively more powerful over non-parametric tests. Yeah. Now, let us see either a parametric test or non-parametric test. When we can say significant or non-significant. For that one, it is decided by two methods. First one is by comparing calculated value and table value. If the calculated value is greater than or equal to table value, at any level of significance, it may be 5% or 1%. If the calculated value is greater than or equal to table value, it means null hypothesis is not accepted at the particular level of significance. It means significance of the data, significance of the test. Similarly, if calculated value is less than table value, then it means null hypothesis is accepted at particular level of significance. It indicates non-significance of the test. It is one way of identifying significant or non-significant. Similarly, simply based on probability value, also it is decided. If we use softwares, we need not compare calculated and tabulated value. directly based on probability value it is decided. Suppose if the probability value of any test is less than or equal to 0.05, it means significant at 5% level of significance. If it is less than or equal to 0.01, if it is less than or equal to 0.01, that means significant at 1% level of significance. By that way, we have to identify either by comparing calculated and table value, otherwise directly probability value. It is just a basic information only. Let us see. Yeah. Coming to parametric tests, already it is defined as distribution of population is assumed to be known. That is normal distribution. Coming to parametric tests, already you are familiar, like t-test, z-test, f-test, ANOVA. Coming to t-test and z-test, first two tests are useful for comparing of means. Coming to third test, z-test, it is for variances. Last one is ANOVA. Already it was covered yesterday. That is through designs. Many designs were discussed. So, we will discuss about t-test, z-test, f-test. Coming to t-test and z-test, both are for testing of means. Then, what is difference between t-test and z-test? Based on sample size, tests will be preferred. If the sample size is smaller, that means less than 35 samples are used in our experiment. Then, to compare means of your data, t-test is recommended. If the sample size is larger, that means greater than 30, then we go for z-test. Okay. With help of SPSS, the tests like t-test, ANOVA can be solved directly. There is options are given directly. But coming to z-test, f-test, we have to write syntax. Then only we can analyze z-test or f-test. I will give you syntax also. Let us see how to analyze this one. Yeah, I have given some brief introduction. T-test, actually it was developed by Fisher. As I already told, it is a small sample test because sample size is less than 30. Coming to t-test, it is basically three types. One sample t-test, two sample t-test, pair t-test. Yes, anyone is asking anything? Okay. Coming to one sample t-test, we are comparing sample mean with population mean. Coming to two sample t-test, here we are comparing means of two independent samples. Coming to paired t-test, we are comparing means of two related samples. Let us see examples first. Here I have given one small example. Here, 10 sheep body weights are collected. From a population, 10 sheep body weights are collected. So sample size is 10. Coming to the population weight is 65. Sample size is 10. So the sample mean is calculated as 60.4. Sample mean is 60.4. Population mean is 65. Now our task is there any significant difference between sample mean and population mean? Sample mean is significantly different from population mean or not? We want to test. So at that situation, we can prefer one sample t-test. Here one sample is there. Sample mean is calculated. We are comparing with population mean. It is about one sample t-test. Already here calculated value is given. After solving this one by using this test statistic, calculated value provided, table value also provided. If you compare calculated and table value, calculated value is greater than table value. If it is like this, null hypothesis is not accepted at 5%. Not accepted mean it indicates rejected. If rejected mean, what is null hypothesis? There is no significant difference between sample mean and population mean. we are rejecting mean, there is significant difference between sample mean and population mean. Coming to two sample t-test, just like one sample t-test only, but the difference is here, two populations are there. As per this example, two diets, diet A, diet B given to students, some people, students or some people. Diet A given to 10 people, diet B given to 10 people. Which diet enhances the weight of people? That is our question. Which diet is better in terms of enhancing the weight of people? For that one, these are two independent samples. If you want to compare which one is a better one to enhance the weight of students, weight of people, then we can use two sample t-test. Here, sample size of diet A is 10, sample size of diet B also 10. We are having data. After taking diet A, these are the 10 students' weight. After maintaining diet B, these are the 10 students' body weight. After recording these weights, we can get the mean. If we have the mean sample size, then you can use the two sample t-test to get the which diet is better to enhance the weight. Here, null hypothesis, there is no significant difference between mean of increasing in weight of animals due to diet A and diet B. Mean, there is no difference between efficiency of diet A, diet B, otherwise you can say. If you see this one, calculated value came 3.82, table value came 2.10. So, calculated value is greater than table value. If the calculated value is greater than table value, mean null hypothesis is not accepted. Not accepted mean both diets are not equal. There is significant difference. One diet is better than another. So which diet is better? Diet A mean value is 27.6. Diet B is 37.3. Obviously, diet B mean value is better. So obviously, diet B is better over diet A. By this interpretation can be revealed by two sample t-test. Coming to pair t-test. Already it is familiar, everyone will commonly use whenever we need to compare samples like before and after situation. At that situation, we can use pair t-test. Here, 10 students were, for example, for understanding sake, I have given this example. 10 students were selected. Without any coaching, they attended for exam. Without any coaching, they attended for one exam. They scored these marks, for example. So it is before situation. After coaching of the particular course, after taking coaching on particular course, they again attended for exam. After that one, they score this marks. Now we want to compare any significant differences there before and after condition. Before and after condition, any difference is there. What it means is, coaching is very effective or not. Coaching improve the knowledge of the student or not. These things will be revealed by pair t-test. Coming to the difference from independent sample test and pair t-test, here, samples are related. What it means is, which 10 students are taken for the before exam, the same 10 students again taken for after condition also. That's why it is also known as related sample test. Coming to here, initially we have to take there is no significant difference before and after. That is our null hypothesis. Anyhow, some test statistic is there. Table value is there. If you compare these two, it will be revealed whether any difference is there or not. Actually, I'm not concentrating much on theory. Anyhow, the same will be do in SPSS. That's why I'm just giving overview only. It is about parity test. Now, coming to Z-test. Already the purpose of Z-test is for comparing of the means. But the thing is, sample size should be larger, that is greater than 30, then only we can use Z test. Z test is two types, one sample Z test, two sample Z test. Just like T test only. Here coming to one sample Z test, just like T test only, here we are comparing sample mean and population mean. Some test statistic is there, table value also there. Coming to Z test, the Z test can't run directly in SPSS. For that one, we have to write some syntax. Then only we can get the result of Z test. Anyhow, I will explain in SPSS whenever we deal the software. Just see one second. Coming to two sample Z test, just like two sample T test also, so two dites are there, dite A, dite B. Coming to dite A, here sample size is 35 taken. To represent dite A, 35 samples are taken. To represent dite B, 38 samples are taken. So just like T test only, but the difference is sample size is larger than 30. So we should not use T test. We have to go for Z test. Rest of procedure is same. For two sample Z test, a particular test statistic is there. And anyhow, table value is there. We will get from table values. So after comparing that one, it will be revealed whether dite A is effective or B is effective. For even two sample Z test also, there is no menu-driven SPSS not there. Only we have to write syntax for even two sample Z test also. After writing this one only, we can follow the two sample Z test. Coming to F test. F test is, the purpose of F test is for comparison of variances. Suppose here I have given one example, two varieties are given, variety A, variety B. In terms of variation, which variety is better? How much mean is very important in any research? Similarly, variance also that much important. So, to compare variances of two populations, F-test is recommended. As it is a simple test, here having simple test statistic, larger variance should be taken as a numerator, smaller variance should be taken as a denominator. By that way, calculated value is coming. If you have table value, if you're comparing with the table value, actually here 10 samples are there. To represent a variety A yield, it is represented by 10 samples. So degrees of freedom for numerator will be 10 minus 1, that is 9. Similarly, second variety B also taken, second population also represented with 10 samples. So it is also taken as 10 minus 1, 9. So we have to take F table value 9, 9 degrees of freedom. So anyhow, we are having table value and calculated value. If you compare this one, automatically we will get to know whether any significant difference is there or not with respect of variety A and variety B. That is also revealed. But coming to F test also, there is no direct menu driven formulas are not there. Only we have to write syntax only. By that way only we can solve. Let us see one by one before going to getting bored. Just I want to...
Hello?
Yes, yes.
Hello?
Hello?
Sir, in T test, you told the sample mean and the population mean.
Okay.
Sir, what is the difference?
What is the difference? Sorry. What is the sample mean and population? Okay, okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. In the... Yes, sir. Sir, if you see this one, suppose in a class, 30 students are there.
Yes, sir.
You conducted one exam.
Yes, sir.
After that one, everyone got some respective marks.
Yes, sir.
If you make average.
Okay, sir.
That is population mean value.
Oh.
In the population, you randomly collected five students.
Okay.
If you take average of these five students only. then that is indicating sample mean.
Sample mean. Okay,
that is population means whole value, whole each and every one value.
Yes.
It is particular.
Sorry, as you told in the t-test, first test, no, sir. There are 10 samples.
Okay, sir.
And the mean of the sample here. T-test, sir. Yes, sir. Here, the sample mean and population mean, sir.
Okay.
Sample mean is 60.4 and population mean is 65, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So taking only 10 samples, you know, sir.
Yes, sir. And it is rough example I have taken, sir. For representation sake. You can take any number, sir, but 5 should be less than 30. You can take any number.
Okay, sir. So in this case, I think taken 5, 5 weights of the seed.
Yeah, Dr. Ramesh.
Hello, sir, sir.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, my point is just sir, please keep your question, note down your question. So at the end of the session, we will take one by one.
Yes,
thank you.
Okay, yeah, Mr. Sir, I will continue. I will come.
Okay.
Yes, continue.
Okay, let us see some of the parametric tests in SPSS. Let us see one sample t-test. Already what we have discussed, same we will do on SPSS. Here, the purpose of one sample t-test is comparing sample mean with population mean. Already the same example, 10 samples are there. This sample data is, I'm entering into SPSS. It is the weight, animal weight. Okay. Already 10 samples of sheep body weights are collected. Let us analyze this one by using one sample. Population mean is already 65. Population mean value is already 65. So let us analyze this one. Go to, for that one sample t-test, select analyze menu, then compare means option, then one sample t-test. Analyze, compare means, one sample t-test. After that one, here your data is labeled with weight. So I am sending this weight option into test variable. After that one, coming to test value. Here you have to write your population mean value. As per the question, the population mean value, population mean weight is 65 kgs. That's why I'm keeping 65 value here. Okay. After writing this one, if you click on OK, in the output view, your result will be displayed. Coming to T-test, test statistic is -2.415. Table value, it is not provided. Directly, probability value is given. If you see the probability value, that is significant value, it is 0.039. If you observe this one, this value is less than 0.05. Less than 0.05. That means it is significant at 5% level of significance. Significant at 5% level of significance. If significant mean, already I told, significant mean, reject the hypothesis. What is our hypothesis? There is no difference between sample mean and population mean. There is no significant difference between sample mean and population mean. As per probability value, we are rejecting. So there is difference. Sample mean is different from population mean. That is the hypothesis. Yes, one second. Yes, two sample t-test is here. Okay. Coming to two sample t test, as I already told, two diets are there, diet A, diet B. For each diet, we are taking 10 samples to enhance the weight of particular person. Which diet is recommended? That is our question. So our null hypothesis is diet A, diet B, there is no significant difference. We have to take like this. There is no significant difference to enhance the body weight with respect of diet A and diet B. If you want to do two sample t-test in case of SPSS, you have to make arrangement of your data. For that one, you have to arrange your data with two columns. Weight you can take. Anything you can take. Weight is one column, diet another column. Coming to weight, diet A, you have to take A, all. That corresponding weight is taken as another column. Similarly, diet B is taken as one column. In the weight column, that corresponding weights are taken. By this way, in the two columns, your data is arranged. After this arrangement only, you can do two sample t-test in SPSS. Let us see that one. I am simply copying this one. Weight and diet values, and I'm simply pasting here. Okay. Coming to first one is weight, second one is diet. Two variables are there. Okay. Now, how you do the for one sample t-test, again go for analyze menu, then general compare means, then independent sample t-test, nothing but two sample t-test. After selecting that one, coming to test variable, that is your weight. Coming to grouping variable, diet will be keep as grouping variable. Now you have to define the group. Two groups are there. First group is A indicated. Second group is indicated with B. After that one, just give continue. Weight, test variable. Grouping variable is diet. After that one, you have to define the groups. Group A, one with A, two with B, as per your question. After that one, if you click continue, the result will be displayed. Here, equal variances, unequal variances, two things are there. Two tests can be applied with equal variances, unequal variances. For that one, it is revealed by Levine's test. If it is a non-significant, then variances are equal. If it is a significant, variances are not equal. Anyhow, it is non-significant. So, if it is a non-significant mean, variances will be equal. So we have to go with equal variances assumed. If you see that one, test statistic value is minus 3.826. Coming to probability value, it is 0.001. So it is definitely less than 0.05. That means significant mean null hypothesis rejected. What is our null hypothesis? There is no difference between diet A and diet B. You are rejecting mean there is difference in diet A and diet B. If difference in diet A and diet B, one is better over another. Which one is better? Diet A mean is 27, diet B is 37. If you maintain diet A, you will get weight 27.6 on an average. If you maintain diet B on an average, you will get 37.3 body weight. So obviously, both are not equal to each other. Diet B is better over diet A to enhance the weight. By that way, you have to give the interpretation. Now, coming to paired t-test, already paired t-test is for used for related samples. Already I have given one example. Without coaching, with coaching. Before marks, after marks. 10-10 student marks are there. Just I have copied these marks. I'm going into SPSS. Just wait. I have pasted this data. First variable is before. Before means without coaching, how is student performance? After coaching, how is student performance? For the analysis of this paired t-test, again we have to go to analyze menu, then compare means. Now related sample, that is paired t-test, related sample test we have to go with. For variable one, you just keep before. For variable two, you just select after value and keep under variable two. After that one, just click OK. If you see this one, significant value is coming as 0.943. 0.943 mean it is greater than 0.05. If it is greater than 0.05 mean null hypothesis accepted. What is our null hypothesis? There is no difference between before and after performance. We are accepting. Because the probability value is more than 0.05. That's why we are accepting the null hypothesis. Mean the coaching is not effective to improve the student marks. How is the performance of student before situation? In the same condition only, after situation also. Coaching is not effective. It is the conclusion. This thing will be revealed by using paired t-test. Okay. Now let us see z-test. Coming to one sample z-test, first clearly understand this one question. Here, a random sample of 15, earlier 10 sheep body weights are taken. Now from the population, 55 sample is collected. This sample mean value is 115. 55 samples are collected, the sample weight is 115. Coming to population mean weight is 100 kgs, we are having already data. This population standard deviation value is calculated as 15. Now, we have to compare sample mean with population mean. One sample t-test also applicable, but based on sample size, it is not recommended because sample size is already greater than 30. So z-test only recommended. To analyze sample mean with population mean, z-test is recommended. For z-test, just like if you go to compare means, there is no option is there. So with the menu driven, we can't follow one sample z-test. For that one syntax is there. As per the syntax, we have to list what the things are required. N indicating sample size. As per our question, number of samples are 55. I have taken 55. Coming to sample mean. Sample mean value is 115 recorded. 115 I have kept. After that one, population mean value. Population mean is 100 kg. 100 I have taken. Population standard deviation is 15. I have taken 15. By that way, syntax have to prepare. Now, as per this test statistic, we have to write the syntax. After I have written anyhow, if you read one by one, initially what we have done, just I'm showing for one thing, x bar minus mu, sample mean minus population mean. in the first step sample mean minus population mean. By that way we have to compute each and every step. Anyhow, I have taken that one, I have written, that's why I'm copying directly this syntax. I am copying this whole syntax. After copying that syntax, you just go to file menu, new, then syntax. After that one, you just paste here. After pasting that one, just select all, select entire syntax. Here run option is there. Just I'm repeating again, file menu, new, syntax option. After clicking this one, this white page is displayed. It is syntax view. You have to paste your code here. After that one, if you click run here, automatically result will be displayed in output view. Just wait. Yeah, now it is coming. Coming to Z, calculated value is 7.42. Coming to table, probability value. Software won't provide table value. Directly probability value if it is giving. If it is less than 0.05 is significant. More than 0.05 is non-significant at particular level of significance. So anyhow, it is less than 0.05. That means significance. So significant mean there is significant difference between sample mean and population mean. By that way, we have to give conclusion. Sample mean value and population mean value is different to each other, not equal to each other. Some significant difference is existing. By that way, we can say. Coming to two sample t-test, here just like extension of two sample t-test, here sample size are taken more than 30 in the both the cases. Here two dites are given, dite A, dite B. Dite A given to 35%, dite B given to 38%. After maintaining dite A to 35%, their body weight's mean value is taken as 27.6. Their 38% body weight is taken as mean weight is 35.3 is recorded. Variance of these 35% is 35.6. Variance of these 38% is 28.68, for example. Now we want to compare which diet is better to enhance the weight of students. Diet A is better or diet B better? If condition is similarly look as two sample t-test, but here we can't run two sample t-test because sample size is greater than 30. So we have to use two sample z-test. Just like one sample z-test only, we have one syntax is there with respect of this mean, this variance, this sample size. Similarly, diet B sample mean variance sample size. After this syntax, just anyhow, I have already prepared, just I'm copying the syntax. Just I'm closing this one. Okay. Now again, after opening SPSS, go to file, open, syntax. Just paste your syntax. It is the syntax for two sample Z test. As per your data, it is your data. Select all, just click on run option. Okay. Here the value is minus 5.78. Here also probability value is 0.00, so on. So it is also less than 0.05. So it is also significant. It indicating significance. Significant mean dite A, dite B are both are not equal to each other. There is variation in between dite A and dite B. Significant difference is there. if the difference is there, which diet is better? As per mean, diet B is recommended to enhance the weight. By that conclusion can be given by using two sample jet test. Now coming to F test. As I already told, F test also there is no direct menu driven. Here also syntax is required. Here two populations are there, variety A one population, variety B is another population. With respect of variances, any significant differences there are not. We want to compare. For that one, I have given the prepared the syntax here. Here, as per syntax, FS equal to first sample size. 10 samples are taken. SS is second sample size. Here, second sample size also 10. I have taken 10 samples. Sample 1 variance is 80.72. It is already calculated 80.72. Sample 2 variance is 13.8. After entering these values, if you select this syntax, just I'm closing this one again and I'm opening. Okay. Now I'm going to file new syntax. After that one, just I am pasting our syntax. After pasting F test syntax, I am selecting entire syntax, then click on run. This value is 5.85. Coming to probability value is 0.01. So this probability value is less than 0.05. That means significance at a 5% level. Significant means with respect of variances, variety A and variety B are significant to each other or different to each other. If variety A, variety B different to each other, which one is better? Which is having least variance, automatically that will be better one. Least variation is there for variety B. So that's why variety B is better than variety A. By that way, we have to give interpretation about F test. These are the some of the basic parametric tests. In the analyze menu, compare means ANOVA also we can run. But already it is, yesterday it was discussed. ANOVA is mainly for comparing more than two population means. Tests are for comparing two population means. Every time you are comparing two populations, ANOVA is useful for comparing more than three population means. Already it was discussed. So I am not entering into ANOVA one way. So I think hope it is clear. I think t-test, like one sample t-test, two sample t-test, paired t-test, z-test, one sample z-test, two sample z-test, f-test. Okay, coming to non-parametric tests. Non-parametric tests can be applied in two situations. To know the relation between variables in one situation, to know the difference between variables in another situation. To know the relation between variables, you can use chi-square test or Spearman. Chi-square test one test, Spearman rank correlation is another one. By these tests, you can get the relation between variables. Whether two variables are related to each other or not. If related, positive correlation or negative correlation or no correlation. By these things will be revealed by these tests. Coming to difference between variables. To know the difference between variables, initially variables are independent to each other or different to each other. Independent to each other or related to each other. Related means dependent to each other. By these things, it is further classified. independent to each other if two variables are compared. Otherwise, more than two variables are compared in independent situation. In related situation, two variables are compared or more than two variables are compared. By this situation, non-parametric tests are classified. Just I'm repeating, non-parametric tests are classified based on two situations. To know the relation between variables, to know the difference between variables. Coming to relation between variables, either chi-square test or Spearman-Rank correlation, to know the difference between variables, it is like variables are independent to each other or related to each other. Based on this situation, it is further classified. If it is independent to each other, then how many variables you are using in your experiment? If you are using two variables only, one different test. More than two variables you are using, then different test. Coming to variables are related. Two variables are using or more than two variables are using. By this classification, non-parametric tests are applicable. Already, first one is to know the relationship between variables, chi-square test. Coming to chi-square test, it is a simple non-parametric test which was proposed by Carl Pearson. Coming to application of chi-square test, the sample size should be more than 30. Sample size should be more than 50. Whenever sample size is more than 50, then only it is recommended. Next one, frequency of any class should be greater than 5. Frequency of any class should be greater than 5, then only it is used. If it is less than 5, some Yates correction is there. Okay, that is different one. Coming to what is the applications of chi-square test? Goodness of fit. It is most commonly used by breeders. They are having some Mendelian ratio like 1:2:1. Phenotypic ratio 3:1, some ratios are there. Whether this expected ratio meets observed ratio or not. This expected ratio meets observed ratio or not. To test that one, goodness of fit is applicable. Coming to independence of attributes, two quality characters are there, like education, region. Whether region influences the education or not. Region influences the education or not. By these two quality characters related to each other or not will be revealed by chi-square test. I have given one example for independence of attributes. In this one, education, two categories are there. Literate people, illiterate people. Coming to region, rural people, urban people. After conducting survey on 104 persons, literate people belongings to rural area 10 were recorded. Literate people may be 10th or something you can keep as per survey. More than 10th studied, urban background fellows are recorded 46 in a college out of 104 students. By that one, it is the survey data. If you assume like it is a survey data. Now, let us compare these attributes, these quality characters, education and region are related to each other or independent to each other. That thing will be revealed by chi-square test. There are some test statistic is there. By using this test statistic, it will be revealed whether both the variables are independent to each other or related to each other. Initially, null hypothesis we have to take both are independent to each other. That is null hypothesis. Initially, we have to take like this. After that one, if you calculate test statistic and table value, here table value is greater than, calculated value or test statistic is greater than table value. So, null hypothesis rejected. What is null hypothesis? Both are independent to each other. We are rejecting mean both are related to each other. That means region having influence on education. Education is influenced by region also. it is like conclusion. By that way, we have to give conclusion in case of testing of independence of attributes for chi-square test. Let us see correlation to know the relation between variables. Already Pearson correlation you might have heard. Pearson correlation is a linear correlation, parametric correlation. Whenever your data is in quantitative form, you can use this one. But whenever your data is qualitative form, you can't use that one. You have to go with Spearman rank correlation. Otherwise, whenever your data is not normally distributing, at that situation, whenever your data is not normally distributing, at that situation, Pearson correlation is not applicable to your data. At that situation, non-parametric correlation you have to try. Non-parametric correlation. That is Spearman rank correlation. For this correlation, there is no assumption. Data not necessarily follow normal distribution. If data follow normal distribution, you can use directly Pearson correlation. What is your regular r, small r? What you use to calculate the correlation? That is Pearson correlation. Can be applicable. Coming to Spearman correlation, for the both tests, some different test statistics are there. For understanding, I have given the example, what is Pearson, how it is coming, how Spearman is coming. If you see, suppose x and y are the two variables. X and y are the two variables. If you see the relation between the variables x and y, if the data is following normal distribution, you can use Pearson correlation. By using Pearson correlation, if you calculate R value, that value is suppose coming 0.72 as per this formula. 0.72, it is a plus 0.72. That means there is a positive association between the variables x and y. That will be revealed. Suppose your data, this x data and y data, whenever not following normal distribution, at that situation, for this data, Pearson correlation is not recommended. At that situation, how can we proceed to know the relation between variables? For that one, Spearman correlation is recommended. It is called Spearman rank correlation. Why Spearman rank correlation? Because it is, this correlation value is calculated by using ranks of data. Instead of original data, this correlation is calculated by using ranks of original data. Suppose in your x is one data, y is another data. Instead of using original data, some ranks will be assigned to particular variables. Minimum value is 47, so it is given first rank. So on, some ranks are given. Second, so on. By that way, 10 observations, so 10 ranks will be coming. Similarly, for y variable also, 10 ranks are coming. After getting these values, by using ranks of data, this statistic will be calculated. That's why it is called as Spearman rank correlation. It is applicable whenever your data is not following normal distribution. That is first condition. Second condition is whenever your data is qualitative data. If it is a qualitative data, Pearson correlation is again not applicable. For qualitative data, Spearman correlation is recommended or applicable. Okay. It is the situation to know the association of variables in parametric and non-parametric situation. Some of the parametric, non-parametric tests I have listed out. What we are going to discuss through SPSS, like run test. The purpose of run test is randomness of data. All the time in case of sample should be collected at randomly. How can we test? How can we know whether that sample is collected randomly or not? For that one, run test is one of the tests to know the randomness of data. Whether your data is randomly collected or sequentially collected. To know that one, run test is recommended. Coming to Shapiro-Wilk test. Shapiro-Wilk test is for testing normality of the data. Because every time data is normally distributed, there is one assumption. How can we know our data is normally distributed or not? For that one, Shapiro-Wilk test is one of the tests, powerful test to know the normality of your data. Already two sample t-test, you know. Two sample t-test is comparing two sample means. When your data following normal distribution. But if your data is not following normal distribution, you can't apply two sample t-test. Even though sample size is more than 30 or less than 30. But whenever you compare two samples means, you can't use two sample t-test. Because your data is not following normal distribution. At that situation, alternative of two sample t-test in non-parametric situation is Mann-Whitney u-test. By this test, just like t-test, you can compare your two population means when your data not following normal distribution. Similarly, pair t-test already you know, for the comparison of before and after situation, before coaching, after coaching, any influence is there, any improvement is there, if you want to test, pair t-test is recommended. But if your data is not following normal distribution, if your data is not following normal distribution, then you can't use pair t-test. Then how can we compare? At that situation, Wilcoxon signed rank test is there. By this test, we can compare. Similarly, already ANOVA one way. ANOVA one way is just like CRD only, completely randomized design. Whenever your data, following normal distribution, then you can use ANOVA one way classification. But if your data is not following normal distribution, then you can't use CRD or ANOVA one way. Then how can you test? For that one, Kruskal-Wallis test is there. Kruskal-Wallis H test. It is also there. You can write Kruskal-Wallis H test. Coming to RBD, ANOVA two way classification. ANOVA two way mean just like RBD. Even for RBD or ANOVA two-way also, data should be normally distributed. In this situation, if not normally distributed, from alternative non-parametric test is the Friedman-ANOVA test. Friedman-ANOVA test is applicable in this situation. So these are the some of the tests which will be going to run in SPSS now. I have not given theory for this one. You just get it from any standard textbook. You can get it. If we discuss theory more and more, hands-on will be, session time will be reduced. That's why just I'm going to SPSS to run these following tests. These are the sum of the non-parametric test. Okay, just to see, chi-square test for independence of attribute. Here, two attributes are there, education and region. Rural, urban. Ah, yes, yes.
Sir, I have one doubt. If any possibility to the Bayesian model analysis?
Which one, sir? SPSS? Sorry, I'm slowly repeat that one.
Sir, if any possibility to do the...
To do the? Yes, sir. Possible to do the? Hello?
Sir, Bayesian model.
Bayesian for this one, not there, sir. SPSS is not that much compatible software, sir.
Okay,
sir. Even it is for basic only, R is better one, sir.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay. Coming to independence of attributes, two attributes are there here: education, region. Coming to education, literate, illiterate. Coming to region, rural, urban. Education having two categories, region having two categories. I have assigned one rank with literate people, two rank with illiterate, just for nominally assigning. Similarly, nominally, I have assigned one value for rural people, two value for urban people. So if we see that one, after conducting the survey, 8 were belongings to rural background with literate, 25 belongings to urban background with literate. Similarly, 26 are particular region with a particular educational background. So literate, rural, 8 are there. So 1-1 combinations are 8 are there. This is 1-1 combinations. Total 8 students are there. 8 persons are there. For SPSS, we need to arrange your data in these two column wise manner. Education, for that one, education one column, region one column. 1-1 combinations are 8 there. Second one, literate urban. Literate urban, that is 1-2 combination. Okay, better here 2-1 started. So 2-1, illiterate rural. Illiterate rural, 2-1 combinations are 20 are there. 2-1 combinations are 20 are there. So that's why 2-1 combinations, I have prepared 20 combinations. Similarly, 1-2 combinations 25. 1-2 combinations I have prepared 25. Then 2-2 combinations I have prepared 6. 2-2 combinations I have prepared 6. So this nominal I have assigned with 1-2 values. I have arranged this data in a 2 columns for education and region. Okay, after arranging this table data in this form, then only you can do chi-square test for independence of attributes. Just I am copying this data. After copying this data, just I am closing all this worked out menus, views. Okay. Okay, I'm just copying here. I'm deleting earlier one. Okay. Coming to first variable is education. Second one is region. So variable 6 is education. Education. Second is region. Okay. Coming to education, label values you have to give. Coming to label value, just see how we have given. Okay. Okay. Let's close it. Again, I'm recapping that one, sorry. First one is education. Second one is the region. Coming to label values, I have assigned value 1 in the education type is literate. Literate I have given. Add. Then coming to value 2 in case of education is illiterate. These two types are there. Coming to region, value 1 is for rural. Coming to value 2 for urban area. Okay, added. Then okay. after defining variable names and label values, coming to your data view, it is a independence of attributes. Just go to analyze menu, then descriptive statistics. Here crash tabs are there, crash tabs. After opening this one, coming to your row wise, column wise. Row wise education is there, column wise region is there. So row wise education I have kept, column wise region I have kept. After that one, in the statistics option, chi square is there. After selecting that one, just click continue. Row wise, as per your data, education is row wise, region is column wise. Just go to statistics, chi square you have selected. It is sufficient. Just click on OK. Okay. If you see this one, okay, your data is arranged like this: education, literate, illiterate, region, rural background, urban background, like this, 8, 25, 26, by that way you have arranged. Coming to this sample, it is greater than 50 is there. At the same time, every frequency is more than 5 also there. Coming to Pearson chi-square statistic, this test value is 16.185. Coming to probability value, it is 0.000 so on given. Anyhow, obviously it is less than 0.05. That means it is significant. Less than 0.05. So reject null hypothesis. What is our null hypothesis? Both attributes are independent to each other. We are rejecting that one. Rejecting means both attributes related to each other. So region is related to, education is related by region. It is a perfect conclusion. Education is related by region. Education is influenced by region. Such conclusion is coming. It is already there one example for goodness of fit. Coming to goodness of fit, there is some expected ratio. Usually breeding people particularly use, like as I already told, some Mendelian ratios are there, like 3:1, 1:2:1, some 50:16, so on, some ratios are there. These are expected ratio. In the field, they will observe some observed ratio. Whether observed ratio, expected ratio, both are meet to each other or not, we want to compare. For that situation, we can use goodness of fit. As per this example, 200 MBA students are there. As per records, 4:3:2:1 ratio, their fail ratio, third class ratio, second class ratio, first class ratio of the students are there. Usually, out of 10 students, generally 4 will be fail, 3 will be third class, 2 will be second class, 1 will be first class. That is their ratio, college ratio. 200 were attended for exam. 200 were attended for exam. Whether this observed frequency also following in the same ratio or not, they want to test. Whether expected ratio, observed ratio are in the same ratio or not. For that one, it will be tested by chi-square test. Just I'm doing it is very simple one only. Just enter your observed ratio first of all. Observed frequency, that frequency value is 46, 68, 62, 24. Four frequencies are there. It is observed frequency. Observed frequency. Okay, I have given. Observed frequency. Oh, I have listed observed frequency. Now you just go to analyze non-parametric test. Legacy dialog box. Just I'm telling analyze non-parametric test. Legacy dialog box. Okay, then chi square. Coming to chi square, your test variable is this one, observed frequency. Coming to expected value is some ratio. What is that ratio? 4:3:2:1. So 4 add. Next one is 3 add. Then 2 add. 1 add. After adding that one, observed ratio is there. That corresponding expected ratio is there. If you click on that one, automatically expected frequency also coming. Corresponding expected frequency also came. This chi-square test also there. Coming to chi-square test, test statistic is 1.2. Probability value is 0.75. So if it is a greater than 0.05. If it is a greater than 0.05 mean non-significant. Non-significant mean accept hypothesis. Non-significant. What accept null hypothesis. What is our null hypothesis? The data observed and expected ratio are, there is no difference. There is no significant difference between observed frequency ratio and expected frequency ratio. We are accepting that one. So in the 200 students also, they are following in the 4:3:2:1 ratio only the result came. It is the conclusion. By that way, we can compare expected ratio and observed frequency ratio. Next. Coming to run test. Coming to run test, we have collected from the population, we have collected some data. Whether this data is randomly collected or not, this data is randomly situated or not, for that one, we have to compare. For that one, run test is one of the tests recommended. Coming to the null hypothesis, data is random. Our selected data sequence is random, that is null hypothesis. Let us check whether that is correct or not. I'm copying this data. After that one, I'm pasting here. I have kept name, analyze, non-parametric test, run test, data. After selecting data, you just need not click anything. Just directly click. After that one, coming to, it is directly provided, number of runs came, 6 runs came. Coming to probability value, that is less than 0.05. It is less than 0.05 mean significant. Significant mean reject the null hypothesis. What is our null hypothesis? Sequence is collected at random. So rejected mean this sequence is not a random data. This data is not a randomly collected data. By that conclusion will be coming. So we can test whether our collected data is random or not. It is for randomness of data. Coming to normality of the data, whether our data is normally distributed or not, for that one you can use either Shapiro-Wilk test or Kolmogorov-Smirnov test. You can use any one of the tests. Let us see your data is normally distributed or not. Anyhow, the same data is there. Just I'm not copying again. Just I'm going this one. Yes. For that one direct option is there, at a time 2 can be generated. For that one, go to descriptive statistics, explore option is there. After that one, go to keep your data and analyze, descriptive statistics, explore data, then go to plots option, normality plots with tests, analyze, descriptive statistics, explore option, under the plots, one direct option is there, normality plots with tests. After that one, if you select the plots, if you select normality plot with the test, if you click on OK, automatically Kolmogorov Smirnov Shapiro Wilk tests will be coming. If you see the both significant values in case of Kolmogorov Smirnov Shapiro Wilk test, both are in the both the cases the value is less than 0.05, less than 0.05, less than 0.05 mean significant at 5%. Significant mean reject the null hypothesis. What is our null hypothesis? Data is normally distributed. Reject the null hypothesis mean our data is not normally distributed. So data is not normally distributed. So distribution of data will be revealed by Kolmogorov-Smirnov or Shapiro-Wilk test. Coming to Mann-Whitney U-test, already it is a analogous or alternative to two-sample t-test. For the comparing of variety A, variety B, two varieties are there. Which variety is best variety in terms of mean value? If you want to compare, t-test is there. But whenever your data series is not normally distributed, at that situation, you can't use two-sample t-test. Alternatively, one non-parametric test is there, that is Mann-Whitney U-test. For that one, initially, just like two-sample t-test only, we have to arrange our data in a two-column-wise manner. Yield is one column, variety number is another column. So, first data set is related to variety 1. I have kept this yield variety 1. For the second set, that is 44 to so on, variety 2. After arranging the data in these two columns, select this data. Okay, coming to first one. First one is related to yield. Second one is related to variety. Number you can keep up with variety number. Two variables are there. Now go to analyze non-parametric test, legacy model. Here two independent sample test. Coming to two independent sample test. Yield is the test variable. Variety number is this one, grouping variable. Yield is your test variable. Grouping variable is variety number. Coming to define group. Group 1 is I have kept with variety 1. Group 2 I have kept with 2 only I have indicated. So just I have continued with that one. After that one, just click on OK. Okay. If you see that one, Mann-Whitney test statistic is 6.5. Coming to probability value is 0.001. So obviously it is less than 0.05. It is less than 0.05 mean significant. Significant mean reject the hypothesis. What is our null hypothesis? There is no significant difference between variety A and variety B. Rejecting that one means there is significant difference in case of variety A and variety B with respect of yield. That will be your conclusion of Mann-Whitney U-test. Just it is an alternative of two-sample t-test. Coming to Kruskal-Wallis H-test. Kruskal-Wallis H-test is just extension of Mann-Whitney U-test. Suppose whenever you compare two populations, Mann-Whitney U-test is recommended. Whenever you need to compare more than two populations, suppose variety A, variety B, variety C is there, variety D is there, more than two populations at a time you are comparing. At that situation, Mann-Whitney is not sufficient. So this is why Kruskal-Wallis H-test is developed. So more than two populations are compared. So here three populations are there, it is different question. Anyhow, with variety C also, you can use Kruskal-Wallis H-test. As per this question, three brands are there with respect of nicotine content of cigarette. Which brand is better? Otherwise, all are equal to each other with respect of nicotine content. How you arranged earlier for Mann-Whitney U-test, in the similarly two columns are required. Brand 1, brand 2, brand 3. Corresponding nicotine content values. 7.7 to 9.1 is for brand 1. 9.2, 8.7 for brand 2. For brand 3, 8.9 to 10 brand. After entering these values in a two columns, just copy this data. I'm deleting this one. Okay, I'm just reducing decimals also. First one is brand. Second one is indicating content, just nicotine content. Brand corresponding nicotine content. It is a Kruskal-Wallis H-test. Here, it is the extension of Mann-Whitney U-test. Mean more independent samples we are comparing. More. Two, if it is a two independent sample, Mann-Whitney. More than two. That is K independent sample. For that one, content, nicotine content is our test variable. Coming to grouping variable is brand. Let us define our brand. Minimum number is 1. Maximum number is how many brands are there. Here 3 brands are there. We are comparing 3 brands. So maximum value is 3. Just give continue. Just click OK. As per Kruskal-Wallis H-test, the test statistic is 4.55. Coming to probability value is 0.10. 0.10 is less than 0.05. The value is less than 0.05. The value is more than 0.05. This is why it is non-significant. Value is more than 0.05. That's why it is non-significant. If it is a non-significant mean, null hypothesis is accepted. What is our null hypothesis? With respect of nicotine content, there is no difference between all three brands. With respect of nicotine content, there is no difference between all three brands. We are, as per this value, we are accepting that one. So, what is the null hypothesis? We are accepting that one. So, with respect of nicotine content, all brands are no significant difference to each other. Yes. Next one is Wilcoxon signed rank test. As I already told, it is a alternative of paired t-test, not two sample t-test, alternative of paired t-test. Whenever before after situation, whenever your data is normally distributed, you can use paired t-test. But in the before after situation, if your data is not normally distributed, at that situation you can't go with paired t-test. Some non-parametric test is required. That is Wilcoxon signed rank test. Before after data I have collected. Coming to variable 9 is related to before, N is after, analyze, non-parametric test, two related sample just like pair t test, only variable one is before, variable t is after. After that one just click okay. If we see the test statistic, it is the probability value is 0.85. Probability value is 0.85, which is greater than 0.05. So there is no significant difference. If there is no significant difference, null hypothesis is accepted. Null hypothesis accepted means, what is null hypothesis? There is no significant difference before and after experiment. We are accepting that one. So how is the performance of before experiment? The same performance is there in case of after experiment also. So there is no improvement is observed. That is our conclusion. By using Wilcoxon sign test, it will be revealed. Coming to Friedman ANOVA test, it is just like alternative of two-way ANOVA. Two-way ANOVA is just like RBD. Whenever your data is following normal distribution, you can use two-way ANOVA, RBD. But sometimes your data may not follow normal distribution. At that situation, you can use Friedman ANOVA, alternative of two-way ANOVA, that is RBD. Here, two variables are there. Two variations are there. One is locations. Here, eight locations are there. Under each and every location, three growth conditions are selected, like lab condition, open field condition, greenhouse condition. Particular variety is cultivated in each and every growth condition of particular location. Now our question is there any significant difference in the yield with respect of growth condition? With respect of growth condition, any significant difference is there of particular variety over the locations? It can be solved by two-way ANOVA or RBD. But coming to data not satisfying one of the assumption normality, suppose that this data is not following normal distribution, then we have to test this data with Friedman ANOVA, one of the non-parametric tests. Just see this one. Just I'm copying this data. Okay, coming to this one, first growth condition is lab condition, second one is open field, third one is greenhouse. Okay, after that one, just go to analyze, non-parametric test, legacy model, k-related sample. Test variables. Okay. If you see that one, here the probability value is coming as 0.043. Obviously, it is less than 0.05. If it is less than 0.05, means significance of test is there. If the test is significant, null hypothesis is rejected. What is our null hypothesis? There is no difference in case of lab, open field, greenhouse condition. We are rejecting that one. So there is significant difference is there in case of lab condition, open field condition, greenhouse condition. All are not equal to each other. There is a significant difference is there. That is our conclusion. In case as per Friedman ANOVA test, which is alternative of RBD or two-way ANOVA. One more thing I haven't mentioned. to know the association of variables by using Pearson correlation and Spearman rank correlation. Just see, I have taken, just I'm keeping, one is x variable, another one is y variable I'm keeping. For that one, Spearman correlation, you just go to analyze menu, then correlate. After that correlate, you just choose bivariate. After choosing that one, keep these variables, x variable, y variable here. After keeping this one, you select a Pearson, Kendall, Spearman, anyone you just select. Pearson is a linear correlation, useful for linear. Coming to Kendall, Spearman, both were for non-linear situation. Whenever extreme outliers are there, Kendall is recommended. Data with not outliers, then Spearman is sufficient, which is based on ranks of data. It is a parametric test. It is a these two are non-parametric tests suitable for non-linear situation. I am selecting Spearman. Just click on OK. Pearson correlation, if it is a data is parametric data, normally distributed data, this value is minus 0.762. That is correlation value. As per Spearman rank correlation, this value is minus 0.783 value. By this way, we can get the association of variables based on parametric and non-parametric situation. These are the some of the topics as per restricted time. I have give some overview on this one.
Sir, may I ask one question?
Sir,
which is the alternative non-parametric test for one sample t-test?
Yes, sir. I have shown this one. One sample t-test. For testing of single mean, there is no particular test is not there, sir. For comparing population mean, mean with sample mean, we instead of going with that case, we just apply suitable data transformation, sir. Okay. We bring to our data to normality by applying suitable data transformation, sir. There is no specific test, sir. There is no specific proposed test is not there, sir.
Okay.
Better we go for some data transformation, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Yes sir.
Thank you so much.
Hello.
Thank
you so much, sir. Can we take some questions?
Yes ma'am.
Question is from Dr. Ganesh Reddy.
Yes.
He is asking which SPSS version is best for use.
Coming to best for use, actually all are paid versions only, ma'am.
Okay,
there is no free version is there. Even if free version is there, but that is limited to 14 days or maximum 28 days, ma'am. So all versions are whatever the latest version available, like 26 is there. If you go with that one, some advanced techniques are there, ma'am.
Okay.
So better go for 26 version, ma'am. More options are there, ma'am.
Okay. Next question is from his side. Can we apply chi-square test for studying socioeconomic variables?
Yes, ma'am. Of course, ma'am. Yes, okay. Ma'am. The particularly suitable for this qualitative data only, ma'am. This chi-square test is.
Okay, next question is from Devendra P. Singh. He is asking why t-test also called student's t-test.
Exactly, ma'am. Actually, coming to t-test, it was proposed by scientist Gossett, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, I'm showing. It was initially introduced by scientist Gossett, ma'am. He contributed under the name of student. His contributions are under the name of student. That's why it is named as student t-test.
Okay, sir. Next question is from Janavi Meher. She is asking how to find out expected ratio to perform chi-square goodness of fit test.
Okay. Actually, to avoid a waste of time, I just skipped that one. Are you getting this one screen, ma'am? My screen?
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay. If you have expected ratio like 4:3:2:1, if you make sum of these all expected ratios, then the total of expected ratio will be coming. What is that value? It is 10.
Okay, sir.
So we have to take 4/10 × 200. 4/10 × 200. It is the expected ratio of first one. Similarly, 3/10 × 68. 3/10 × 68. By that way, if you calculate that one, corresponding expected frequencies are coming.
Okay, sir. Next question is from Pramodini Tarai. She is asking, what is the difference between parametric and non-parametric test?
As already we have discussed, whenever data having an assumption, that is, population is normally distributed. Otherwise, known population, data population is known. Population distribution is known. Then we can use parametric test. If there is no assumption, population may follow any one of the distribution which is unknown, then non-parametric test is recommended.
Okay. Last question, sir. What is the importance of pooled mean?
Pooled mean. Okay. Whenever you go for multi-location experiment, ma'am, at that situation, pooled means are coming, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Hello, sir. Hello. Hello, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Hello.
Sir, how to come to know the data is following the normal distribution curve? Because we are handling 100 students and scoring marks between 62 even 90-95. So how to arrange or whether this data has come under the normal distribution or not? How to know or how to, is there any procedure to know that?
Yes, sir. What is your minimum value and maximum value of your data, sir?
60 and 90, sir.
You can initially, you have prepared some frequency distribution, sir.
Oh.
Based on your bin value, you have to prepare some classes, sir. Like 40 to 45, 45 to 50, some classes you have to prepare, sir.
Okay.
Based on that one, there is actually in SPSS also, SPSS not there, sir. In Excel also we can do, sir. After having classes of frequency distribution, normal distribution can be prepared, sir. By that,
sir, way, hello. Hello, sir. Can we use this SPSS for our combining ability test or heterosis breeding test, heterosis breeding, or any other planned breeding method?
No, sir. It is not that much sophisticated, sir. Instead of that one, all some online software, sir, there, those are better, sir. Otherwise, Flix or these softwares are better ones, sir. For heritability, heterosis, these are not portable ones, sir. For
this. Okay.
Sir, I want to ask, whether you have to test the significance of R value on the basis of R table value or T table value?
Please, sir, loud, I'm not here. Significance of what, sir?
R, correlation coefficient.
Okay, sir.
So, whether it is tested significance on the basis of R value table or T value table?
T value table only, sir. T value only, based on sample size is decided by significance is with T value only.
Okay.
Sir,
is it necessary to check normality for all type of analysis, sir, before going for
if you want to know the true difference of the treatments, it is necessary, sir.
Okay, sir. Even though parametric test, we have to test normality before going for analysis.
How much if you want to make accuracy? How much you want to try to error, na, sir? True performance will be revealed.
Okay, sir.
To know the true value, for that one, we are trying to reduce all kind of errors, sir.
Okay, sir.
Then better will be revealed. Better thing will be revealed. That is the thing.
Okay, sir. Oh, so before going for any T-test or ANOVA?
Any parametric, yes.
Any parametric, it is best to go for...
Better.
Normality.
Okay. Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. Okay. Sir, to develop and standardize socioeconomic scale for farmer, which kind of test we have to apply for that?
Socioeconomic. Sorry, sir.
If you want to develop socioeconomic scale and standardize it, which type of scale and test we have to use?
What kind, sir? I mean, which kind of data that is? You may take nominal data, ordinal data, any kind of data you can take, na, sir.
Okay.
All may not be nominal data, all may not be ordinal data. Based on data to data, it is different, sir.
Okay, okay.
Based on data only, we have to go, sir.
Okay. Thanks.
Yes, sir.
Hello. Sir, I have a question in run test.
Okay, sir.
Sir, in run test, you have taken the null hypothesis as there is randomness. Oh. While in other cases, you have taken there is no significant difference. But in run test and that normality test, there yes. you have not taken no there. So why is it so?
Why is meaning actually it is proposed by World Wolfowitz. Some scientists are proposed. Sir. Accordingly, we are applying that.
Okay, okay.
So there is no like conditions are there.
Okay, but generally we take no significance there, no? Okay.
No. If you apply some in time series analysis also, like augmented decay failure test also, not there. Sometimes yes also there.
Okay.
Every time not that one, sir. Some are yes, like yes there.
Okay.
Yeah, Ramesh. Thank you very much for nice lecture. And a very informative also. So I think there is no end of the question and answer. So I will request to just write your email ID so people can contact you in later on also.
Yes, sir.
Because after 1.5 hours, 2 o'clock, we have to start another session also.
Yes.
So
sir.
Yeah. So people can take lunch and everything.
Yes, sir. Finally, I would like to thank you for the society for giving me the opportunity and all participants for your patient listening. Thank you, everyone. Thank you all.
Yeah, I would request to all participants also just write down the Dr. Ramesh's email ID and they can ask their queries in email also, please. Seema ma'am, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Now I close the. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
May I close?
Yeah. Just say thanks to Dr. Ramesh also once again.
Yeah. Okay.
Then we can finish.
Thank you so much, sir. I deeply appreciate the wonderful presentation and hands-on training on SPSS, chi-square, t-test, everything whatever you have presented here. I hope participants have enjoyed and learned a lot with this. It is very much useful to all of us. Again, sir, thank you very much. Thank you so much, sir. And thank you all the participants also.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Next session, we will start at 2 p.m. About the multivariate analysis. Thank you all.
Thank you so much, sir, for a very nice presentation.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir.